His thoughts towards you, God's thoughts towards you. I'm sure you should be happy about that, to know that God is thinking about you. The Bible reading for today is taken from the book of Isaiah 55, verse 8 to 13. Isaiah 55, 8 to 13. And memory verse is taken from the book of Isaiah 55, verse 8, which says, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither your ways my ways, says the Lord." The Lord says that His thoughts are not our thoughts, neither His ways our ways. The Almighty God has special and specific promises for His children. So you have a hope, and I have a hope. These promises are great, and their operation is not dependent on the condition of the economy of the nations where His children are located. And that means that no matter where you are, no matter what is going on, where you find yourself, the promise of God can still locate you. Now, when the Lord says it is well with you, He's not saying this because of the things around you. He's saying so because of the things that He is capable of doing. Remember that God honors His word. So there is an assurance in God. Why? Because there is no impossibility in Him. Man can fail you, remember, but God can never fail you. His thoughts and His promises towards you are great, and they are perfect. I think that's the good news. But there are some keys that are required to unlock these promises. And one of such keys is found in the book of Psalm chapter 37, verse 37. Psalm 37, verse 37. It says, "Mark the perfect man and behold the upright, for the end of that man is peace." Now, the key from this scripture is righteousness. Righteousness is the key that ensures and guarantees the enjoyment of God's blessing in this world. Righteousness guarantees your enjoyment, guarantees your peace and access to God's promises. God knows how to settle you, even though others are lamenting. This is because His thought towards you are not a function of the economy. God does not work with the economies of this world. And so whatever God has said concerning your life, nothing can stop it. We must therefore ensure that our stand for God does not change even in hard economic times, because God is not moved by the economies of this world. We must remain righteous both in season and out of season. We must keep our place and stand firm in God. Others may compromise righteousness, maybe for the sake of gain. But you, as a child of God, you must remember the promises of God concerning your life. That must be your guide. That must be something that should be able to guide you. Now, an example is Joseph. If Joseph had compromised his stand with the wife of his boss, seductively approached him, he would have not emerged a deliverer in Egypt. As a matter of fact, that opportunity would have destroyed him. As a child of God, your trust must be in the name of the Lord. Everything that the branches needs is supplied by the vine. Remember, Jesus is the vine. We are connected to Him as the branches. Philippians chapter 4 verse 19 says, "But my God shall supply all your needs according to His riches in glory by Jesus Christ." So there is hope for you. You can come out of that problem. Therefore, trust in God's promises and hold on to Him. He will not fail you. Remember, it is a disaster to put your trust in any man. But when you put your trust in God, your blessing is assured. That is an assurance for you this morning. And I pray that God Almighty will turn every of your sorrow to a testimony for you. Shall we just bow down our head and pray briefly? Almighty and everlasting Father, we trust in your promises. We trust that your word can never fail. And so, Lord, I pray for everyone that is listening to me right now. Let your thought come to manifestation in their life. Even though everyone around them is saying there is a casting down, give them the grace to say there is a lifting. Change them, O God, and give them a testimony. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. God bless you and have a wonderful day today. Remember, it is ART TV, Open Heaven Outline. See you again tomorrow. God bless you. Open Heaven.